Ruchit Jain, equity analyst at Angel Broking, is now joining in. Ruchit Jain, thank you so much for taking out time for us. Ruchit, can you just first start by the bottom that we made today, 6,963. We did not go back to the levels that we were a few days back. Is that encouraging, and a recovery from there tells you that we are in a process of a lower top, lower bottom formation?
Yeah, good afternoon, Pankaj. Well, if you just observe last few days what markets have done, in spite of being such a volatile trading sessions every day, last week Friday, amidst volatility, the Nifty had formed a bullish hammer pattern on the daily charts. Although this is a reversal pattern which has been seen on the daily charts, and weekly charts have not shown any such reversal or positive patterns being formed. So this is indicating that on a short-term time frame, the markets should show a pullback move. Although it won't be a bottom unless we see any meaningful reversals on the weekly charts. So a pullback move towards 7200, 7240 is quite possible. This was the January low which was breached last week. And the support which was breached, should now act as a resistance. So till we are holding above the low of the hammer made on Friday's trading session, which was around 6870, I think we are in for a pullback move up to 7200, 7240 range.
Right. Do you think that it's the first time in the last few days where bears would be a little worried? Monday we had a big move on the upside. Today we have recovered quite a bit from the lows. You think that they would be in a hurry to cut their position rather than only the bulls?
Mangaj, it would be led by both short covering as well as a bit of long build up in individual stocks. Markets are at support levels, and formation of these reversal patterns on charts shows that some kind of recovery would be there. And what we have seen in last one and a half months, the fall in the Nifty when it was there from 7,500, 7,550 range, the fall was very sharp. So generally, when the fall is sharp, the pullback move also tends to be very sharp. So what happens then when such sharp pullback move comes? It comes along with unwinding of the short positions as well as some sort of long build up. So I think it would be combination of both. Short positions would get unwound over here, and along with it, some fresh long built ups would be seen, which would lead to a faster move towards 7240.
Right, but after 7240, you think again markets would have to test? They would see some resistance over there.
Yeah, there would be resistance over there. As I told earlier, that the longer time frame charts, the weekly charts, are not showing any kind of meaningful bottom in place yet. So this is just a pullback move. We may extend about 40-50 points beyond the 7240 also, but overall it would again would be the levels where any kind of long positions should be booked profits in that zone. But as of now, still we are far from those levels. We are about 130-140 points down from those resistance levels. So I think for short term traders who are looking to trade for the rest of the week, from here on, I think they should trade with positive biasness. And although Nifty is 100-130 points away from that resistance, but stock specific, you would see much stronger moves in this 100-140 points rally.
Whenever we would see such sort of a movement coming in with Nifty being so volatile, it could essentially mean a change of a trend as well. Basically, bulls and bears are fighting in, and that's why we are seeing extreme volatile moves.
Pankaj, change of a major trend cannot be seen unless we see major reversals on weekly charts or on monthly charts. So what happens that when you generally see lower time frame charts and hourly charts, reversal on the hourly charts or daily time frame charts would generally just suggest that yes, the trend would reverse, but for that short duration only. We have seen a correction of in the markets of almost 1 year now. And a major reversal of 1 year's correction cannot be there unless we see any kind of reversal or any kind of buying coming in from the weekly charts or monthly charts. So longer time frame charts are still not supporting any kind of major reversal. Hence, we are not anticipating that this volatility would lead to a bottom in the market, and again markets would resume the uptrend which was seen a year back. I think these are not those times yet unless we see any kind of reversal on weekly ones. Pullback moves would be there. We have seen in last 10 months, sharp pullback moves of up to 300-400 points was not a big thing after markets have corrected sharply. So this would be just one of those pullback moves itself from here onwards. So one should not anticipate a big reversal and a resumption of the uptrend from current levels. But yes, it's just a temporary bottom that market have made, which should lead to this sharp pullback up move.
What do you make of Bank of Baroda? You think it's a name which is looking good, at least the recovery that has happened in the last 3 days?
Yes, last 3 days, the stock is showing strength, especially after the results when it opened the gap up. The good thing was that after that gap up opening, the rest of the day was backed by very good volumes. So basically, a good volume upside breakout with good volumes indicates a short-term positive momentum in the stock. Last 2 days, again, after correction, today we are seeing that from the lower levels, the stock almost retraced about 50% of those gains and again have started moving up. I think in next 3-4 trading sessions, the stock would head towards 147-148 range. So the biasness should be positive in this stock for short-term trading.
Right, but now that it's already up from the levels of 118 where it closed on Friday to 138, should one take a breather and only if there is a decline one should buy? Because as we have been speaking, markets could be quite volatile before they actually go up.
The declines were already there. We have seen that on Friday's trading session, the stock closed at 138. And today, if we see, the stock had made a low of 126. So this is what I told about 50% retracement of that move. So no, declines were already there. And I don't think that the stock would again come down in a day or two. It has again bounced back from its support zone. So probably I think it would head towards 147 without any correction from current levels.
Right. So that's Bank of Baroda. Some of the other PSU names, interest in PNB is very high. Interest in SBI is very high. Similar charts, or probably if you want to stick to PSU, Bank of Baroda is a better one.
From PSU space, Bank of Baroda and State Bank of India, these are the two stocks, which could be seen from a short-term trading perspective. Even SBI, we have seen that it's trading around its long-term support zone. Last 2-3 trading sessions, it has been volatile in a range, as we have seen with other stocks. But what we have seen that a sharp pullback move also could lead this stock SBI up to 178-180 range. Apart from these two stocks, other PSU names, although they may give a pullback move if SBI and PNB, if SBI and Bank of Baroda gives a pullback move, but I won't advise to create any long positions over there. These are in a downtrend. These are continuously forming low top, low bottom formation. And after this pullback move is over, when again the correction starts, these would be the mid-cap PSU banks would be the first one to again correct from higher levels. So one should stay away from PSU banks even though they give a meaningful bounce from current levels. Prefer large cap stocks such as SBI and Bank of Baroda, that too only for short term trading. SBI can be bought here from about medium term perspective as well. Otherwise, from banking names, if we see, then Axis Bank would be one of the preferred names among the entire banking names. This stock, if we see last 1.5 months, what it has done, it has been consolidating sideways after a downside momentum. And when Bank Nifty has corrected in last 2-3 weeks, we have seen that the stock has not corrected. So relatively, we have seen some outperformance in Axis Bank. And a consolidation phase after a downtrend generally indicates accumulation taking place. So we believe that the downside is very limited in Axis Bank from current levels. And this stock could give significant returns on the higher side. So if anyone is looking to buy anything from banking space, then Axis Bank would be the preferred pick at current level. And from PSUs, one should only look at Bank of Baroda from short-term trading perspective and State Bank of India. Rest of the PSU mid-cap banks should clearly be avoided, even if they gave a meaningful bounce from current levels.
Right. What would you make of Tata Motors? It's again one of the top gainers in the last 1 hour, closer to 312.
Yeah, this stock could see some buying interest coming in near term, Pankaj. We have seen that last time when it made a low of around 280 was in September 2015. From there, it gave a meaningful bounce up to 440. So that was quite a good move from 280 to 440. Again, we have seen the stock correcting around those levels and is taking around those 275-280 support range. Last 4-5 trading sessions, the stock has shown good volumes around that support zone, which indicates some sort of buying taking place in this counter around 275-280 support range. we are anticipating an up move at least towards 338 and up to 350 in near term. So one should clearly trade with positive biasness in Tata Motors for trading perspective.
Right. Adani Ports, it's classical short covering sort of when you look at the data, when you look at the volumes. But do you think Adani Ports can go back to the 240, 250 mark where it was facing a lot of resistance?
Again, this would be one of the short covering candidate, I would say. If we take a bit of charts of 1 year or more, then the stock is already forming lower top, lower bottom formation. 240 was a major support for the stock, which was not breached for one and a half year. But in the month of, in the start of the Jan itself, the stock had breached those levels. So this clearly indicates that the stock is in a downtrend. A pullback move again up to 235, 240 cannot be ruled out. So those who are already long in this stock at any levels, if the stock comes around 235, 240, that in fact should be used as an opportunity to exit from the long position rather than creating long position for a move up to 230,
35. Right. What do you make of a name like Just Dial? Almost about 20% gain from the low, in fact, even about 25 rather. You think that has made a bottom or clear indications that a bottom has been made?
Well, Pankaj, overall the trend is still down in the stock. It's been, I think, from August 2014, so almost 1.5 years where this low top, low bottom formation is in place. The stock around from its all-time low levels, the stock has moved higher. And definitely, if we just observe last 1.5 months, the stock has corrected from 800 to 400 levels. So almost 50% correction in last 1.5 months we have seen. So even if the stock moves up by 20-25% or 30% in a day or so, that won't, traders should not get too much excited by this move. Definitely it could be just a short covering move because the stock has corrected about 40-50% from its highs. And such short covering moves, even if the stock comes around 600, I think the stock would again resume the its downtrend from there. So one should clearly not do any kind of bottom fishing in this stock. Stay away. The sharp pullback rallies, once they are over, the stock would again head lower, and it could again retest those 400 levels which were recently seen.
Right, Ruchit, thank you so much for taking out time for us. Always a pleasure.